Welcome to Life Talk 21, the show that is designed to motivate you, to inspire you, and to give you strategies to help you live in the 21st century. And not just live, but we want to be successful. And I'm your host, Eric Wortham, behavior specialist, educator, speaker, author, and naval disabled veteran. And I want to come to you today. I want to keep it short because I'm preparing to eulogize a very dear person in our family, young lady that passed. And, you know, a lot of people, we're still having a hard time dealing with this one, because she was such a good person. And again, she wanted to be better. She recognized that there was areas in her life that she can grow. And she would call me to ask questions about how do I get there. And so, you know, we lost a great one. But today, again, I just want to talk about don't risk it, you know, because there are times in life that we really could prevent things by using preventive measures or being proactive. That's the one thing that I learned, even in as a Christian, is that God wants us to be proactive in these things. And so I want to talk to you real quick about don't risk it, because a lot of times, again, we can prevent certain things from coming about or from happening in our lives if we were to take the proactive approach. And so one of the things, two things that I want to talk about today is high-risk choices, low-risk choices. And that's what I do when I talk to people. When I do drug, alcohol, risk reduction, these are the things that we're trying to get them to understand. Through everything that we say, it's all leading up to understanding high-risk choices, low-risk choices, okay? So first, let's talk about high-risk choices. High-risk choices are those choices that we make that put in jeopardy the things that we value, okay? Family, our job, our homes, our health. You know, they put in jeopardy those things, because when we make the high-risk choices, the chance of problems happening is great. It's great. It's like magnified when we make high-risk choices. For example, if, you know, I know I'm intoxicated, you know, I drink way too much, I smoke way too much, or whatever, if I decide to get behind the wheel of a vehicle, that is a high-risk choice, because the chance for something happening is very, very high. Now, a lot of times, because we get away with it, often we don't really think about it. We don't, until something devastating happens, like we have experienced in our family. And it's tough. It's really tough, because not only did it affect that person, but it affected somebody else. You know, somebody else lost their life in the course of the situation. Now, and I don't know the whole thing, but this is an opportunity to understand that a lot of times when we do things like that, we are making high risk choices, and we want to avoid those things, because, you know, you got family that's involved. And, you know, when you have family that's involved, you know, it affects everybody, you know, and everybody is hurt by this situation. And we pray for one of our family members that survived. We continue to pray for her, because God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above anything we can ask or imagine. You know, and it was an accident. When it comes down to it, it's an accident. You know, it's not something that they tried to do. It's not something that they woke up and say, hey, let me have an accident today. It's not. It's an accident. And so we pray for them. But we have to, young people, we have to learn how to be diligent in making these high-risk choices, because, again, they can affect your life in a major way. you know, high-risk choices, again, you know, it could be doing those things. It's high risk if you, if your girl asks you, she put on something new, and she asks you, how do I look in this? Anything other than the positive, like great, magnificent, awesome, is high risk choice. Anything that you say that is not positive, like, you know, you look great or something like that, you're making a high risk choice. And so that's what we're doing. Our choices put us in a position where, you know, we can, where trouble and problems are magnified. And then we talk about low risk choices. Low risk choices are those choices that we make that protect those things that we value, our family, you know, and it doesn't mean that something cannot happen because we make low risk choices. But what it does mean is that the risk of something happening is very small. And so that's what we want to do. We want to reduce the risk. And that's, you know, that's what I teach. And those principles are good things for us to be able to take a hold to. Because this is how we want to be when it comes to drugs and alcohol. And I'm not one to say it's not, you don't need to do it. I'm not, because again, at Prevention Risk Institute, we've done the research. So we've seen the benefits of alcohol, wine, and how it increases the blood flow and has a role in preventing, you know, blockages. Like, that's why people have strokes and heart attacks, because their arteries or veins are blocked. And it, wine, that's why people in Europe drink wine, but on a regular basis with their meals, because it does have some medicinal purposes, because everything God made has a purpose. Paul even told young Timothy to drink some wine often for your sickness. So it was a medical remedy back in those times. But the problem is that they were not addicted to it, and they did not go beyond the limits. And we teach limits at PRI, you know, no more than 3 drinks a day. That's it. And, you know, other things, you have to be moderate with these things and stay in the safe standards. Now, and I'm not going to talk about all the standards. I'll do that in a future podcast where I do longer. But basically, you want to have a take it or leave it approach when it comes to drug and alcohol. That means that I don't have to have it. I'm fine, man. I just don't have to have it. Because a lot of times we get into social dependency where, you know, we can't be in social situations without drinking or smoking. You know, that's called social dependency. And when we get in those states, you know, we tend to make a lot more high risk choices. State-dependent restriction is another thing that we talk about. That's when, you know, you perform something well while you were high or drunk or whatever state that you was in, but you performed it well in that state. And so your brain remembers that. And so now you can only perform in that state when you have reached that same high or that same, you know, you drink the same level of alcohol or got to that same point, because that's what it does. It changes your brain. And so we want to stay in a place to where we have a take it or leave it approach. You know, oh yeah, I'll do one with you. Okay, I'll drink one with you. But it's not that I have to drink one with you. I have to smoke one with you. And so that's what I wanted to talk about just for a little bit today is high risk and low risk choices, because that is really what it comes down to, making high risk or low risk choices. Remember, high risk choices, they protect those things that we value. Low risk choices protect those things that we value. High risk choices put in jeopardy those things that we value. So we want to make sure that we're making low risk choices. We're focused on that. We're doing the things that we need to do so that we can protect our families, man. Our families are the ones that get hurt most often. in situations like that when we make high-risk choices. I'm Eric Wortham. Be all you can be by doing all you can do. Thank you.